All right, so in this video, I'm gonna just show y'all how I kind of paint my lettering wood sign. And this is it right here. I already carved it out, kind of sanded it. So it's just ready to paint. And I'm gonna just kind of show you how I do it. So that way maybe some of y'all get some tips and know how to do it. Or can do it like me. So this is a brush that I'm going to use. You can use your type of brush, but this is what I'm going to use. Alright, let's get down to painting. It's a little time consuming, but it's well worth it at the end. And the reason why I do this is because, like, I can get real fine on the edges and not worry about going over or getting messy. For right now, I'll just do the top. And after I'm done with these paintbrushes, I throw them away. So I find some, you know, cheap ones. I went to Ross actually, and man, I found a whole bunch of brushes for real cheap, so I ended up buying a whole bunch of them. So once I use them, I throw them away. So I'm just doing an example on this piece right here. That way you can kind of see how I do this. I try not to get the letterings. So I guess you want a brush that's real fine and no way you don't get paint everywhere. I'm gonna end up burning this right here, and then I'm gonna sand it. So you'll see here on the video how I do that. So this is the tricky part, is just being patient, just getting the edges. Doesn't leak so bad, so doesn't look like crap. Just take your time. Want it to make it look nice. There's no rushing. Sometimes you might have to move the wood around to see if you got everything right, but I'm just doing a quick tutorial to kind of show you how to do this. So just put on some music, get a nice cold beer, just hang out in the shop and do your thing. This is kind of like a little stress relief for me, you know. And this can, I bought it, I think, if I'm correct, I think I bought it at Home Depot. So And there it is. That part's done. So now you know. I'm gonna go ahead and finish the rest, but kind of get the idea of what I do, how I do this. Appreciate it. And there you go. I finished it up. Now time to finish the rest. Alright. Now I'm going to blowtorch the sides of the name with this blowtorch right here. And I'm just going to blowtorch the sides. So here we go. So maybe what I should have done is probably burnt it first, then painted it. But it's okay. I got a few little burnt marks right here. So I'm just going to sand that down and then repaint it. So quick little fixer, but not done yet. Looks like crap, but not done. Now I'm going to stain this area right here. Then I'm going to stained in mahogany. So I went back and sanded the J to get that burning off of it. So I'm just gonna repaint it, and then I'm gonna try and sand it just a little bit so I can get the wood grain to show with the paint. If you see, I sanded it here just a little bit, and this is kind of like the look that I want right here. So I'll repaint it cherry black, let it dry for a little bit, and then come back and sand it just a little bit and get it back to this color right here. There you go. I applied more black cherry on there, and then I just let it dry for a few seconds. And actually, I didn't sand it. I just went in there with a paper towel and just kind of slowly wiped it, and that's the effect that I got. So I like it, and time to finish the rest. So I'm gonna get ready to paint the mahogany. This is the stain that I'm using. Hopefully I got a good look at that. And I'm just gonna paint like this around the J. The rest of it, I'm just gonna go over with the cloth. So I'm just gonna show you how I do this. And I just did this so I don't get no paint on the J, since that's a different stain, which is that cherry black. And that's it. The rest of it I'm gonna do with a towel. And the rest I'm just gonna do with the towel and finish it up, and I'll give you how it looks when I'm done. And this is what it looks like after I done stained it with mahogany stain. So now I just gotta go back and sand the name, and it should be done. So let's go sand the name. I went back and touched up the little spots that I hit with the sand, and everything looks great.